Today, I'm going to show you how to make pemmican. First, you start with some meat. You want to dehydrate it. Then you're going to need fat. And in this case, hard tallow that I melted down on a stove into a liquid. And then I poured that liquid off and let it cool till I got a white consistency like that. After that, you need the meat. Here is some bison. In this case, I'm using bison and moose. And I slice it thinly like this, and I lay it out onto the dehydrator racks. You can also use the oven set at about 170. The dehydrator, you want to set at about 175. It'll take about 12 hours, and here's what it'll look like afterwards. Once it's dry, you want to get it really dry so that it's almost brittle. And once it's nice and dry, you're going to want to pull it out of the dehydrator, and you can crush it up into a powder. A blender is a great thing to use. It works really well, but you definitely want to make sure it's nice and dry, and that'll ensure that the pemmican will last for months on end in the trail. So throw all that into the blender and then blast the blender and get it to where it is nice and pulverized. Could take a while. You need to stick a spoon in there or something and just, you know, stop it, stick a spoon in, push it around, get those chunks down to the bottom, but eventually it will be completely blasted into powder. And Huddy's chiming in with a couple little pointers here, I think. And finally, after your meat is powderized, you can pour it out into a bowl. And at this point, you're probably going to want to just filter out all the chunks of dry connective tissue. That will just give the pemmican a smoother flavor. And, you know, basically most of the nutrients are in the meat itself. So I just use an orange juice strainer, and I'll just take some time to sift out all those kind of larger chunks, and in the end I'll get a better tasting final product. And that sort of fluffy connective tissue is a great little treat for the dog. So let's see if my 8 month old son Huddy likes it.
Icing. Moose. 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 That's moose.
Next, you're gonna wanna use berries. I bought frozen blueberries, thawed them out for this, and just blasted them in the blender. Although fresh wild blueberries do taste better, they can take time, and buying fresh blueberries is more expensive as well. Here I blend them up. You don't wanna blend them up too much, or it can be challenging to drain the water out of them. So another good way to do it is you can put them in a Ziploc bag and squish them with your hands, drain out the juice, and then dehydrate the remaining that way. But the blender works pretty well. But before you throw it on your dehydrator, you're going to need to kind of customize some parchment paper to fit. So you can do a two-fold system here, which is what I'm doing, and just kind of eyeball out what the middle air vent in your dehydrator is going to take up. Cut it out like that, and that's what you're going to want to put your pureed berries onto. Of course, you can use other kind of berries, Saskatoon berries, cranberries even. I've even used raspberries before. And Huddy's toy is making a little sound here. That's fun. You can all enjoy that. And so then you're going to want to dump out the pureed berries out onto that sheet in the dehydrator. I have multi-levels in my dehydrator here, so I go ahead and fill it up completely, fill up both of my dehydrators with the blueberries here. That took three of the large size bags of blueberries. And if you don't have a dehydrator, if you run out of dehydrator space, you can always use your oven. I set mine at the lowest it'll go, which is 150, but you could go down to 130, might be better. And I just fit all those pulverized berries in there, and it'll take a while. The berries are going to take longer than the meat for sure. Just dialing it into 150 here. And I stick a spoon in the door, and that way it lets some of the moisture escape and it's less likely to actually bake or cook. And after a long dehydration, at about 135 in the dehydrators, 150 in the oven or lower, you get it as brittle as possible. Sometimes you get that kind of fruit leather texture. You break that up as small as you can. And again, you just blast those berries down and you just powderize them. I'm using the blender here, which works great. And there we go. Yeah. Just dump off those pulverized berries into another jar. And they're pretty tasty just like that. Nice and dry. All the big chunks are gone. And in this case, I'm going to try using some lard, which is pig fat. You can just buy tender flake, which is hardened lard and melts very easily. And then I'm starting to measure. So I'm measuring out my meat and I want equal parts. So that's the key. So in this case here, I'm doing, you know, equal parts pulverized meat to equal parts pulverized blueberries. And I dump those all into a bowl together. Doing two batches this time. I'm doing some moose pemmican and some bison pemmican and keeping them separate. And yeah, want to make sure your measurements are pretty bang on. It's equal parts of everything, equal parts meat, equal parts berries, and equal parts rendered fat. So we go, that's the rendered pork fat or lard in this case, and I'm measuring out the same amount of liquid lard as I measured out for the meat and the berries. I'm just mixing it, pouring it all in together, just like that. And of course, this lard, when it cools, will harden up again. And here I am just mixing that all together, giving it a really good mix. And once it's all mixed, I pour that out while the lard is still nice and soft. And I just line up a dish with some parchment paper and flatten that all out. And next step is to just let it cool. So after I get that reasonably flat, I just tuck it into the fridge, which speeds up the cooling process, and we'll get it into kind of bar formation. So here's the finished product. This is the moose pemmican here. And that's cooled down just about enough for me to easily be able to cut it up into bar form. And I like to store it with a little bit of parchment paper in between. Here's me divvying up the bison pemmican here. You can see it's this part's a little crumbly. This batch might have been able to take a little bit more of the animal fat, but to any excess pieces that crumble while you're breaking it up, you can just squeeze them together in a ball. And in the end, I put them into Ziploc bags and wrap them in cellophane, and then I take them out on my canoe trips. There you have some delicious pemmican.